I can remember the doctor working with it was a resident, and he drew a picture of this flower, and he told me to draw it, and I couldn't. And I thought, this is weird.
Paul Munns remembers feeling strange the day he began his MS journey more than 20 years ago. He was in medic school and forced to stop his studies when his MS failed to go into remission.
When you're sitting at home and you're sitting there and you're watching the world go away, it's like, you know, what in the heck's gonna happen?
He had worries after being diagnosed, worried he'd need to use a wheelchair or whether he could even join the fire department. He convinced his superiors to let him try and has been a member for 26 years. He's learned to live with the autoimmune disease that more than anything leaves him tired.
If you look at MS, MS is, if you think of like a cord, like an extension cord or regular cord, the actual, what we call the myelin, which is the actual wrapping of the nerves itself, is kind of eaten away.
Multiple sclerosis affects the central nervous system, disrupting the flow of information within the brain. More women than men develop the disease, and most are diagnosed between the ages of 20 and 50. Paul isn't the only member of the department to be impacted.
My younger daughter, Brittany, was diagnosed with MS 7 years ago. And since that time, our family has jumped in to volunteer on several events, including the MS walk that's coming up in May. We have a team called the Multiple Scleracers.
There's no cure for MS, but the National Multiple Sclerosis Society invests 83% of its donations on research. Supporters raise money and awareness through annual events. Ron Hawkins assembled the MS 150 team in honor of Paul and other members of the White Bear Lake Police and Fire family.
One of the things I want people to know, that if I come out to help you, you have nothing to be concerned about as far as you're not going to get it from me. The second thing is support, you know, for the organization, because they are trying to find a cure.